unlike Gujarat, where a lot of, you know, where people encourage you to start your own businesses and the culture is, you know, that way, South Indians are very different. You know, they believe in a completely secure environment, and they have only three career options for their children. Yeah, three IT companies. One Wipro, two CTS, and three CTS. PCS. And so, after my engineering in Chennai, and then my MBA from Symbiosis Pune, I decided that I would take up a job at Wipro Technologies. It was a very safe pre-placement offer. I did my summers there, decided to take it up. So with that in place, I was very happy. I was going to take up a job. And then there was one person I met who completely changed my decision. So there was this lady who I met through a common friend, a very interesting lady, who was working with tribal women in rural Maharashtra. She was designing these products for home, you know, like cushion covers, pillow covers, quills. Not very big products, but small products. So she was helping these tribal women earn their livelihood by selling these products. Very nice design, simple design, but very good. Now I'm going to talk more about design, because at that point in time, I don't even have so much idea as well. But what happened was, I found that though, in spite of, you know, these being very nice, sadly she did not have a channel to market these things. She would sell it to friends, family, you know, people, word of mouth, you know, but nothing beyond that. So in fact, even I met her through one of my friends who had one of her small products. So I met this lady and I decided, she had loads of inventory piled up and she had no clue where to sell. So I decided that I'd put up a small exhibition in my college. So anyways, you know, as second year students, you have nothing much to do in college. So we decided, okay, it's a very interesting project. Got together three or four of my friends. You know, we put up some notices. You know, very interesting thing while you're in college, you know, a small time thing. So one exhibition led to another. And at the end of the second exhibition, we completely sold out. We didn't, and we had more orders as well. So this decision changed my, you know, changed my idea about the whole thing. Now, I no longer wanted to take up a secure IT job. I wanted to do something different, because I saw that all the proceeds were going to rural households, which is really going to help those women, you know, better their lives. So I chucked my Wipro job offer and decided to take up a rural marketing stint at Whirlpool. So this girl from Chennai, who's lived there for 21 years, okay, decided to go all over the country selling refrigerators and washing machines to villages. So I've traveled to Punjab, stayed in interior villages, you know, places like Mirajwala, Sindar, you know, places I do think are even very visibly written on maps. You know, Uskia villages in Tamil Nadu, Karnataka. So after a year and a half, you know, I had traveled everywhere and I had a really good idea of how rural marketing works, you know, how villages function, how people there buy. I had quite a good idea about all these things. And then, interestingly, I moved on to another role in Mars Chocolates. Mars, Snickers, you know, very interesting. So I moved there and I worked there for a year as the head of business development for the West region in Bombay. The other perk was I'd also put on 10 kilos with all the chocolates that I was eating. So, but that, I was very happy with my job. So another incident happened which actually changed the course of my life again. You know, I'm actually being lucky here. So a friend of mine, who was a very good friend at that point in time, and that was my husband, introduced me to two guys who are from NIT. These guys had an idea about an online marketing portal for handicrafts in India. Being design students, they were looking for somebody who would help them in sales and marketing. You know, supply chain has a lot of constraints, production has a lot of constraints, you know, things like that. You know, being from Whirlpool and Mars, you know, we are totally trained on this, 12, 13 hours of the same thing. And then I came here and I'm like, very interesting. So I came down to Ahmedabad and met them over a weekend, a Saturday, Sunday. Just came down to chill out with friends, you know, a nice break, because Mumbai being a big city, Ahmedabad was a good break. So I came here. So in that weekend, we made a business plan, made a presentation. In the following week, we presented that to the government for a loan. And surprisingly, I mean, very surprisingly, because I am somebody who really thinks that governments don't work that fast. Okay, in a month's time, a loan was here. And Kata Handicrafts Private Limited was incubated by NTPR, the incubation cell at NIT. So that's how Kata started. So I go back and I put in my papers at Mars and I decide to move to Ahmedabad. And here, my friends, my family, they were not willing to support me at all. No, they thought it was a very wild thing to do, an impractical decision. Who would want to, you know, quit a very nice, comfortable job with a very good salary? My career is going very well and I'm giving you a promotion. Decide that opportunities don't come your way all the time. You know, I was very, I mean, something inside told me that I'm going to miss this bus now. I'm never going to get another bus to get home later. So I decided to follow my heart, quit all this, move to Ahmedabad and start coming. So a year and a half almost later, it took us some time to actually start the business. There were a lot of compliances that come with setting up a private limited firm. I realized after I came here. It took us, and about a year later, I'm here. And I can tell you, there have been testing times. It's not like I come here, you know, I make my products and have 10 clients standing at my door. So that has never been the case. Whereas my previous organizations, Whirlpool, Mars, we always have a ready client there, you know. Our only job is to manage stocks, which is not a very difficult thing at all. But here, coming here, is setting up something new. I do not have an educational background which goes with this. But then I realized, you know, that going forward, slowly things take shape. So a year later, I am here, willing to take this to another level. And I have decided to take an education also in terms of design. I started taking up a design course, and so I'm going to be busy with that for the next 6 months. And the other perk of starting your own thing is, of course, it gives you a lot of flexibility to explore your creative side, explore things you want to do. I've taken up photography as a hobby, I'm doing that very seriously. So many things, you know, which I really don't think I had time at all. I was busy preparing for IIT exams, CAT exams, or, you know, I was busy, you know, preparing for my sales stuff. Things like these that keep happening and never let you explore that side in you. I think my own venture has given me that kind of opportunity in spite of being very challenging and very intellectually stimulating as well. And coming back as a woman, what do I think? How has it been different? Honestly, the answer is no. Because I have worked in very male-dominated domains. Channel sales, FMCG, you know, rural markets. These are not places where you will find women at all. I worked there and it hasn't been difficult. The initial days, you know, obviously men, I mean, as everyone mentioned, don't trust women that easily because they don't see women bringing stability. You know, in fact, a boss would, you know, I mean, he's right when he thinks that a girl working for him, eventually in a year or so, you know, she'll get married, then she'll move on, or in a couple of years more, she'll want to start a family and then she'll move on. Women always tend to prioritize their family over work, you know, I mean, it has been true. But the time frame they are in, they're bringing a lot of dedication and sincerity. You know, that is again a pro working with a woman. So these things in place, I have had my frustrations, but I've slowly gotten over them. A very interesting incident that has, you know, amusing incident that has happened to me is, as a part of a sales target achievement, you know, we achieved a huge sales target, my entire team, and we all were flown to Bangkok as a treat, you know, for our sales achievement, which is 41 people, 40 men, and one lady, and that's me. And this is in Bangkok. Yeah. So after 4 days in Bangkok, with 40 other guys, you know, previously colleagues and now, I have very different opinions about everyone. Yeah, after 4 days of weathering that storm, I was very clear. It is not difficult to survive in a man's world. For a woman, it is not difficult at all, trust me. So with that newfound freedom, I came back. And of course, the second thing is that my husband is also an entrepreneur. So the environment has grown and been very supportive and very encouraging. You know, and he also has weathered all these storms, you know, that has come in his way. So we discussed that, you know, and he's done it a little ahead of me. So, you know, I can get a lot of, you know, mentoring and get a lot of feedback from him. And in fact, there are some cases where I haven't had to go through a lot of mess that he has been through. You know, he actually forewarned me about that. So that has been very supportive. So these two things have, you know, been very helpful and not deterred me as a woman, you know, in what I wanted to do. And what people, I'm sure there are some people here who want to start something and, you know, who are doubtful about it. Things, you know, maybe it will work, maybe it won't. I might waste a year, you know, what will I do? You know, but I think you should follow your heart, you know. It isn't all the time, you know, that you get an opportunity. It isn't all the time that you get your calling. You know, if you get it, you know, you have to go ahead and do it. It might fail, I mean, there are cases, you know, you might not be successful all the time. But the failure, the amount of knowledge and the experience and the person it makes you is definitely worth all the effort and all the doubt. You know, I'm somebody who listens to a lot of music and, you know, I can get very inspired by some songs. You know, very, you know, in fact, during the break also I mentioned something. So, you know, there is something that I always tag to my, you know, wall, my study wall. You know, it says, it's actually a song called Eye of the Tiger, so it was just talent, so the guys might actually relate to it a lot more. So, it's by the American rock band called Survivor. It goes like this. So many times it happens too fast. You trade your passion for glory. Don't lose your grip on dreams of the past. You must fight just to keep them alive.
Anybody has a question for her?
She goes too fast.
Sir, as a company which is also included in MBA.
Yeah, I mentioned your interview.
We just had a brief. I mean, how much is the turnover, if I am to ask you, if you don't want to keep more secret, some revenue turnover you guys have done?
Right now we are only at 25 lakhs. We are very small.
25 lakhs is a good amount. Okay, and in terms of the money which you got as a loan, that was part of MSME or, you know?
It was not part of MSME.
The division setup that you
were getting
5 lakhs.
Yes,
that was the first one.
That was the first one. We have not received any grants. This is a loan from the government. We're quite comfortable and we think that. We just have one employee in our organization, and we have a lot of volunteers who work at research for us. And predominantly the design is done by my colleagues who are designers, but they could be sales and marketing.
So, Anika, basically you are designing or you are procuring it from various markets?
It goes like this, you know, there are some handicrafts which are good to be sold by themselves, you know, which are good enough, the quality is very good. They're also relevant to people that who can use them. But there are some crafts, you know, which are very good, but they need some design intervention, then they need some finishing quality, or they need to be adapted to something that you can use. You know, there aren't too many people who want to buy like a huge, you know, 5 feet painting. Nobody wants that, you know. Whereas that adapted to something usable by a lot more people, you know, is what we're going to take handicrafts a little further, you know, closer to what people can actually use.
I overheard, I guess, from you or somebody that most of your sellings are taking through internet. Is it that way, or how you are getting onto the client?
We started with an idea of an online forum for selling handicrafts. But what happened was, you know, we were working on the forum, we started with a blog, actually, you know, where we get research for handicrafts. So in this, once we started sales, we started doing it through word of mouth, through some corporate clients. And then we also set retail stores in Bangalore and Mumbai. So now we are working towards setting up a website. In another 3 or 4 months, we should be up and running with our idea is we want to make such a beautiful website, because that is what we've been working on for over a year. Craftsman gets the maximum mileage out of it. He gets it to us, he gets it to somebody else, you know, we are very happy.